David Aldridge on our sideline, and here with me, Greg Anthony and Steve Smith. This is Kevin Harlan. It's the Orlando Magic and the Chicago Bulls.
Been a nice clean game, huh?
It's going to be the Bulls off the tip. Now the starting group for Orlando. The big man are Gordon and Vucevic. Fournier out there with Shelvin Mack. And it's Batum and at the three, the small forward.
And that had to be a defensive mix-up. They know he can hit from that spot.
Yeah, big miscommunication early. They allow his first points of the day.
Side pivot. Let's it go from 11. Here's Grant. 2 points. That one goes. Grant's got his first 2 points of the night.
And setting the tone early with a strong move to Brack.
First quarter, you're really testing the defense, trying to find their weaknesses.
Yeah, good awareness there. He sees an opening and doesn't hesitate.
A lot of laziness going on out there still early in the game, but that needs to get worked out.
Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Well, Frank Vogel had a few minutes to share with me. I asked him about the challenge of playing against a team that's so smart and under control on offense, and he said they really do a terrific job of execution. No miscues or missteps. We need to be just as disciplined if we're going to get the upper hand. And since they're down 1-0 in the season series, they'll have to do that really well tonight.
David, thanks as always. Their goal early on is a simple one, keeping those opposing shooters from getting hot.
Yeah, and so defensively, they can't get tied into any one strategy. It might take a few different approaches here before they find one that works.
Greg, the reason why is you're never sure which of their shooters is going to get hot. The matchups will change depending on who's doing the most damage. You know, the offense has just looked out of sync. Only
he's going to put that one in his scrapbook. Insane dunk.
And now they're starting to rub it in. Build up a lead. And here they go. It is showtime. And the highlight reel replay brought to you by Under Armour. Another Unleash Chaos moment. Excellent work by the talented people in the production truck as well. Now here's Matt. Just 5 on the clock. They get a hand on it. Vucevic takes it into the teeth of the D and converts the layup. On defense, Orlando. Trailing by 4. They are coming into this having notched a win against the Knicks in their last game.
And I know the defense wasn't great, but yet it's still their ability to stay composed was impressive.
Those things come too easy. It's easy to lose focus, but they held each other accountable and played hard.
Orlando shooting their first shots of the night from a charity stripe.
Yeah, pretty good numbers on the season when you look at their free throw attempts, right around 78%. And Batum brings length and a versatile game to his spot on the wing, and his defense always a big asset for this team. He's the kind of player that everybody needs to have out there, kind of a glue guy. And defensively, this is a nightmare. He's already on a roll.
Well, obviously, this was a strategy coming in. Feed him the rock and let him go to work.
Vucevic with the bucket. The Bulls leading by 3. Here's Jordan.
And guys, that's not as easy as he made it look. You've got to have some skills to pull that off.
Well, he's got plenty of those, that's for sure. Gordon the screen. Oh, and a fast break for the Bulls. And he lays it up and in. Vincent's got his first points in this one.
And the story here, Kevin, early on, is how well they shot the basketball.
Gordon dishes to Matt. Gordon a screen. And Batum makes a Fournier. And the three ball is good. Fournier's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. Here's Pippen, and the Bulls tack on 2 more. The Magic trail by 6. And Mag kicks to Vucevic. And he banks in the layup. Vucevic has got 8 points.
Really, really good at recognizing the gaps and getting the ball to play.
Grant the pass to Pippen. Outside for Jordan. And he makes the bucket. Drew Konjac and gets the whistle too.
And the game plan is is clear. Work the ball inside.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
And you know, guys, he had a big game at the free throw line in their last outing.
Free throw good, Jordan. The Magic trail by seven. And Mag kicks to Vucevic. Shoots over front right, and it's Vucevic missing. Hits on the pass to Jordan. Let's go with the three. And the ball's coming back. And slammed on by Jordan.
I mean, already hot coming into the game. Is it fair to say he's hotter?
We've got 1:55 left in the first quarter. And Mag gets to Vucevic. Picked his pocket. Here's Jordan. Chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark. 16-51. Here's Vucevic. Here's Mag. They get it back. The Bulls leading by 9. Pass to Jordan.
Build a big lead like this, especially early, you have to guard against the letdown.
Yeah, this is where it gets interesting. Do they start to coast, or do they go right for the juggler?
Here's Jordan, and sticking right with it, gets the foul with the bucket.
You got to give a ton of credit to the screener. That play easily opened up the easy layup for his teammate.
Giannis Hassel, he's checked in for Horace Grant. There's the basket. Back to Pippen. Good ball moved by the ball. Vincent the pass to Pippen. Over by 2. That's your locker rim. The Magic trail by 8. Wide open. And it's Hanslam with the rebound.
He can't find his mojo. Tough quarter for him scoring the basketball.
Michael Jordan again. Jordan's got 16 points.
See, this is how you dictate the flow of the game. He's been lit this quarter.
And Mag kicks to Batum. Pass to Vucevic. And Mag has it in the corner. And the 7'1" Bill Cartwright steps for the rebound. Hassel dishes to Pippen. Jordan the screen. Pass to Vincent to the inside. It's stolen by Vucevic. And so it's the Chicago Bulls going into the break with a 10-point lead. The Philadelphia Company shooting the ball with great efficiency, dictating the pace. And
it on fire, all period.
Here's Mac. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. In a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. So on the floor for Orlando. Gordon out there with Hazonia. Then there's Wayne Ellington. Then it's Sheldon Mack. And it's Hernan Gomez in at the pivot spot, manning the middle.
And a lot to dislike about that. I don't know where to be at.
No, not at all. Me either. He doesn't want to look at his coach or teammates. I'm sure he's going to get an earful.
Nice work to get it inside and draw contact.
No good on the free throw. And he sinks the second. Orlando with the ball. 11-point game. Gordon with a screen on Pippen. Outside Gordon. Now here's Mac. He's covered closely, and he gets the bucket. Mac's got it back down to a single-digit deficit for the Magic.
And that's why teams work so hard to get the ball inside. I mean, those high-percentage looks and keep the buckets flowing.
And that's a great pass. Danny Green showing us he can do more than D it up and three it up.
Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Back to Ellington. 6 on the shot clock. Gordon a screen. Here's Azania. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
And of the last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is just smash by physical basketball, guys.
And plenty of contact on the shot. So, 2 free throws coming up. And the foul goes against Orlando. Bulls shooting their fourth and fifth attempts at the free throw line tonight. That free throw, no good. Changes for Chicago. Sellers checked in for Cartwright. Jordan comes in for Green, and Vincent subbed in for Paxson. And a change for the Magic. Isaac's checked in for Aaron Gordon. Orlando with the ball, trailing by 10. Ellington kicks to Hazonia. Inside, here's Isaac. The rebound by Pippen.
And you can see at this stage of his... Wow, and that sort of showmanship is just deflating right now to a team trying to get back into a game like this.
Greg, that is definitely an emphasis jam, a big apostrophe or exclamation point, maybe even a question mark. Ellington's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. Back to Pippen, expanding his range. That's another one for him, his fifth in just seven shots.
And that's from beyond, guys, right back at you.
This is looking more like an all-star game right now. Everyone launching from range.
Poke loose, and out of bounds in Chicago gains possession.
I mean, clearly not on the same page right there. You hate to give away possessions.
Pass on the screen. Here's Jordan. Ah! Pass to Vincent. Out to the wing. Second chance shot. Eyes yet again. Haslam can't get it to go.
That's just two tough competitors meeting right at the rim. Someone, in my opinion, had to lose.
Last outing for Chicago, they won that game against the Denver Nuggets, and the basket is good.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Here's Mack. Hooked away.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
The pass to Sellers. Back to Jordan. Gets it to fall, and now he's 10 of 15 on the game.
That's all confidence right there. He knows he's in a groove, and they've got this team on its heels.
Back the pass to Hazonia. Over to the left wing to stop the run. Another miss by Orlando.
I'll tell you, he just hasn't been able to get it done on the offensive end. It's kind of dragged down the team.
Hansen gets hauled in by the Magic.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Finish now to Ellington. Some nice ball movement by the Magic. Five on the clock. Here's Mack. The Magic again can't hit.
It's been a frustrating quarter for him shooting the basketball. He just has to make sure he's taking good shots.
Pippen misses. The Magic trail by 16. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
The drive by Jordan. Pippen dishes to Jordan. Tries again. Jordan with another miss.
Unfortunately for him, the defense is so react, but he couldn't make the play.
And on the defensive side, just a failure to match up.
Well, the one thing you want to take away is anything at the rim. Just too easy.
The tray, that doesn't go either for Jordan.
You know, I'll tell you, he's got nothing here in the second quarter after just one made shot in the first.
And he just leaves the D in the dust and explodes to the basket.
You're right. Maybe a momentum changer right there, huh?
I think it very well could be. That might be the game-changing play that helps push them over the top.
I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already here is eye-opening.
Hazonia, good, and the nice assist from Mack. Hazonia's got 7 points here in this quarter.
It's amazing. He is on fire here in the second period after going scoreless in the first.
Whoa, Vogel taking it to the rack with power, hammering down the two-hand slam. Here's Isaac, and again it's Orlando with the three.
Yeah, that's too good a look to give them from behind.
Here's Jordan. Gomez grabs the miss. And Gomez has got his fourth rebound in this one. Azania's shot is off. The Bulls winning by the time. Here's Jordan. It's deflected.
And that long wingspan of Isaac aids him there in turning away shots, but it's also the timing he displays when he attacks the shooter.
Watch outside!
The feed now to Ellington. And it's going to be a 3-second call. Just 4 seconds left to play in the first half.
The defense will do a good job of pushing off the metal there.
Start here just a few moments. What a game we're seeing from Michael Jordan.
Yeah, so far they haven't found an answer for him. A scoring machine here in that first half.
Defensively.
And Orlando has possession. It's a 10-point game. They got Vincent. Pippen is out there with Grant, and there's Cartwright, and it's Jordan in the two. That's the five out there for the Bulls. Six to shoot. Here's Vucevic, and with that one, the lead is trimmed to single digits. Vucevic has got the first points of the second half up on the board for the matchup. And there's Michael Jordan, the assist by Pippen. And the Bulls lead by 10.
And each bucket at this point feels like a backbreaker.
Showing no mercy. Double-digit lead and still putting it on.
Plus 8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control. And that's how you want to come out of the locker room. He is fired up.
Yes, in the first minute or so, you knock down a couple of shots. You are in rhythm.
Fournier with the ball. He's picked up by Jordan. Great sequence for them defensively and offensively.
Terrific defensive instincts to come away with that one, and he showed no hesitation in how he completed that transition opportunity.
Time call here. The Magic decided to talk it over.
And hey, Jim, they've been committing a lot of turnovers here. Taking care of the basketball is the number one priority right now in that huddle. They've got to tighten it up.
On defense, the Bulls. Now Mack, and Fournier kicks to Gordon. Gordon a screen, 6 on the shot clock. And Nicholas Batum with the slam.
Yeah, he just punched the ticket on that one. That'll get the job done.
Powerful two-hand jam. Shoots from 12. Rebound by Vucevic. Vucevic has got his third rebound tonight.
After hitting 3 straight, they finally missed one. But you can see the rhythm coming out of the half.
And Jordan has it in the corner. Shoots over Fournier. Michael Jordan again. Jordan's got 32 points in the game.
He's in control when it matters, giving them a tremendous advantage right here.
Gordon kicks to Batum. And it's tipped out of bounds as Orlando keeps possession.
Magic ball.
Here's Matt. Jordan with the rebound.
And there have been some terrible shot choices here.
Beautiful.
Wow. We are going to remember that one for a while.
I know I will, Greg. That was special. That was really special. And Matt kicks to Vucevic. Goes up the baseline. The shot comes out. Now Chicago takes it the other way. Outside Jordan. And he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact.
And he'll go to the line for two. Against Grenadier, Aaron Gordon. The Bulls have shot 3 of 5 at the foul line. And the first one at the line is good. And so Jordan nails both of them. Well, the NBA has taken great strides to ensure a competitive balance, Steve, over the past decades, but they have a long way to go to achieve complete parity. I don't know that it can ever be done. How do you feel about the current competitive balance of the league right now?
I think it's good. Kevin, you're totally right. You can't get complete parity. You don't have injuries, and I think when you have injuries, it changes the whole dynamic of these teams. So far, so good for me. I think there's a lot of balance. Good teams are good for a while, and then it always shifts and changes. I think we're in good hands right now.
Grant, right side. Pippen against Batum. It's stolen by Mack. Launches a three. Gets all in by the Bulls.
Well, they've been better than good on the glass.
Way up there.
And it's been about that execution. Offensively, I mean, they have been superb.
That's what's extending this lead. The right plays, right time, and good finishing.
Vucevic setting the pick for Batum. Knocks it loose. Pippen, the pass to Curry. Mobs it up for Jordan. But they recover it.
Wow, another opportunity. Just everything going their way. Pretty much the story of this game.
Another shot. Count it. Jordan's got 42 in the game.
And this has been a great job of just getting into the middle
of
that defense and really scoring effectively from the paint.
Now a timeout called by Orlando.
And the amount of points they've given up here in the paint, that's what you got to talk about.
You know, for the most part, their perimeter D is holding up, but they might have to sacrifice some of that to close down the lane.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Green's checked in for Pippen. And it's Paxton in for Vincent. Hernan Gomez is checked in for Orlando. Ellington comes in for Mack.
Not letting his team down. He's been very strong. He just needs a little help from his teammates.
And they double up Jordan to the inside. Here's Paxton. That drops and it comes off an assist from Jordan. Paxton's got his first basket of the night.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
There's the pick. Ellington dishes to Gordon. Back to Ellington. 11 feet away, and that's collected by Grant. Grant's got his third rebound tonight. And slammed up by Jordan.
He has taken it upon himself to score the ball as much as possible for his team. He's not looking to pass it right now.
Here's Fournier. And he banks in the layup. Fournier's got 8.
And not relying at all on the three-point shot. They may want to rethink about stretching the defense a bit like they did in that first half.
And they double up Jordan. Pass to Carter. Green kicks to Jordan. Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. Shot clock at 5. Cartwright misses.
Yeah, the aggressive D inside leads to a missed opportunity there.
You know, he had terrific position. He did a good job of affecting the shot without fouling.
Another fantastic offensive rebound and put back. This is the second game in a row where he has just been ball dominant.
When he gets into one of these grooves, you never know how long they're going to last. Sometimes they go on and on and on.
Well, 3 quarters of play, down double digits, it may be difficult to overcome. Bulls lead by 8 here in the fourth. The Bulls leading by 18. Fourth quarter on the floor for the matchup. They've got Vucevic. Ray Ellington is out there with Evan Fournier. Then there's Hernan Gomez. And it's Hezonja in at the small forward. Now here's Ellington, guarded by Paxton. He's looking for Jordan and finds him. And they double up Jordan. Here's Fournier. He dishes it to Vucevic. And here is Hernan Gomez over Haslam. And that misses badly. Air ball.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know. Up by a bunch, he's still pushing the action, trying to impose his will.
With this big of a deficit in the score, you'd think the losing team would be playing harder. Nope, the opposite.
Ellings in the pass to Hazania. Free throw line jump shot. And it's put back in by Vucevic. Vucevic has got 9 points now in just the second half.
Oh, how about the finesse? A nice little gentle touch on the board.
And you know, when you have that gentle touch, those tip-ins are easy to come by.
He's really cooking right now. He's having a phenomenal half.
And the Magic with possession.
Timeout
called by Orlando. And across the NBA, we've seen players taking a vocal stance on various social issues. Swin, you think that's pretty important?
Very important. And I think this generation has done it better than my generation. Obviously, speaking out, but yes, they're using their social media tools to come out and talk about important issues. The one thing you just want to bring light to these issues, and hopefully, a lot of people, the more light you bring, the more solutions, I think, will come about.
Let's go home. That was just ridiculous.
I do not remember the last time I saw a dunk like that in a game. Ellington dishes to Fournier. Brennan Gomez kicks to Ellington. Feeds it to Vucevic. Plenty of space. Rebound by the Bulls. Jordan's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Here's Cartwright, and a jam by Phil Cartwright.
And putting in the work on the boards, and it's paying off with chances like that.
And gee, he does win the rebound. That's why he's on the finishing end of one putback slam after another.
He just never gives up on any play, any shot. He's always battling in the paint. He's one of the best at that position.
Here's Azania. Chicago grabs the miss, and here's the fast break. Jordan leading the way, and the shot by Jordan.
And when you can outscore your opponent in transition, that's always going to work to your advantage.
The reason why a number of guys on this roster, they are built for speed. Why not play their strengths?
Well, flying high and throwing it down with the one hand.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys. This is it to Baxter. Right side, Pippen. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. That one a little long.
Not sure of the thought process on that one. Really bad shot selection.
Well, you're playing for the team, not just yourself. They needed much better execution that trip down the floor.
Here's Jordan. Here's Cartwright. A strong finish under heavy pressure all over.
And defensively, they're on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Paxson against Batum. Hazonia kicks to Batum. They set the pick. 4 on the clock. And caught. That one goes careening off the glass. And they double up Jordan. Pass to Sellers. Outside Jordan. Rebound by the Magic. Here's Isaac. Dishes it to Spates. Lets it go from 11. Tries again. And they will get the basket here, folks, as they move the team.
Barely too late and catches it on the way down. He's already in the air there, committed, so can't fault him for going for the block.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. He's checked in for Buckley. Haslam comes in for Pippen. And it's Green in for Jordan. And a switcher also for Orlando. Ellington's checked in, so Chicago ends up going with a new group. And they double up Jordan. And it's Jordan with the jam.
And that's the classic 1-2 punch right there. I mean, nice feel. And how about the elevation, Kevin, on the finish?
And great, nothing spurs some quick offense like a great play defensively.
When your defense translates into offense, it's a beautiful thing.
The Magic making a switch here. Isaac's checked in. Time called here. The Bulls decide to talk it over. They're ahead by 26. We've got 1:55 left in the fourth quarter of this one. And now let's present our Jordan player of the game, Michael Jordan.
And it's been a ridiculous performance in the best sense possible. I mean, everything about his game has been working. And no matter what they've thrown at him, he's had the answer.
The better he played, the more these fans got revved up. And that continued to play out over the course of his amazing performance. Here's Matt. He's 6'11 footer.
Shelvin Mack does a great job playing within his team's offensive schemes, a guy who has the complete trust of his teammates.
Chalk up two there. Jordan's got 56 points in the game.
And a high percentage look there, and he takes full advantage. Bumps up the lead.
Yeah, the lead now is double digits. Some tricky matchups out there, not a lot of solutions. I like what he's doing here. Terrific efficiency scoring the basketball.
Rebound by the Magic. Vucevic has got his eighth rebound here tonight. Pumped loose. Kicks to Fournier. Outside Jordan. Uses the glass to finish the lay. Jordan's got 58.
Yeah, the onslaught continues. He's been unstoppable now for a couple of nights.
The momentum is building, scoring in a bunch of ways. That's why his number keeps getting called.
Back the pass to Fournier, six on the shot clock. The first one falls. And so Fournier nails both of them. 51 seconds left in the game. Here's Jordan. It's stolen by Vucevic. Mack with the ball. He feeds it to Fournier. Good, and a nice assist from Mack.
And this run may make the score look a little more acceptable, but still a loss.
They could never put it together when it mattered. Just let too many opportunities slip through their fingers.
Got a piece of it, and stolen by Fournier. Here's Vucevic.
And on the defensive side, just a failure to match up.
Well, the one thing you want to take away is anything at the rim. Just too easy.
And just staying aggressive, continuing to extend that lead.
They left nothing to chance. This is how you close out.
And so Chicago takes this one, and by a big margin. It was a tale of two teams tonight. One that was in total control, operating flawlessly, and the other just searching for answers that they could never find.
I mean, the energy here is just so tremendous. Fans involved from the get-go, and once they started to really pour it on, it was fun to see that rhythm and flow from their perspective.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it.